Welcome to Necromunda Hired Gun. Amber here with 5 tips that I wish I knew when I started playing this game. This game has an unusual inventory management system that isn't explained very well, but is quite extensive. First thing to keep in mind, there's no button on your controller or keyboard to open your inventory. You access the items you own by interacting with the various people here in Martyrs End, your home base. Talk to this weapons dealer here to not only buy new guns, but also to sell items that you've already collected. And on Xbox, you use the Y button to switch between the buy and sell modes, which I just did here. So my second tip is to pick up any items you find during missions, since you can always sell them when you get back to base here, and use the credits to buy weapons or upgrades that you actually want. So you can buy weapons from this gun dealer, and then to buy upgrades for yourself or your Cyber Mastiff, you need to go to the Rogue Doctor right across the way. The Rogue Doctor here is similar to the Ripper Docks in Cyberpunk 2077, if you played that game, where it was called Cyberware, but here it's called Augmetics. Augmetics are those upgrades to yourself that grant you additional stat boosts or additional abilities or skills that you can then equip and use in combat. Many are available immediately, but some need to be unlocked by first purchasing and upgrading other augmentics or modules. So the first option I picked here was to upgrade myself, my bounty hunter body, but the other dialogue option here when talking to the rogue doc is to upgrade your Cyber Mastiff. And yes, your dog has its own upgrade tree, which I think is pretty awesome. And one of the unique things about Necromunda Hired Gun compared to other first-person shooters is that you can take your loyal companion pet with you into battle and upgrade his abilities if you find yourself taking advantage of them. Speaking of your dog, third tip, you can pet your dog. Just go to the right of the bar and interact with your Cyber Mastiff. The first time you do it, you'll actually get an achievement or a trophy, if you care about that sort of thing. And if you do, don't miss the shooting gallery up the stairs here. The first time you complete all the targets, you'll get another trophy or achievement. And I actually missed this shooting gallery until hours into my playthrough because I thought the sign was just part of the atmosphere, but no, the sign that says shooting range actually is a little shooting range here that you can use. So tip number 4, this shooting gallery in Martyrs End is a great place to try out new weapons or new weapon upgrades like scopes before going in on a mission. How do you equip different weapons without starting a mission? That's a question I've gotten. And that's my tip number 5. My final tip, how to equip weapons. Go to this computer screen here, across from the entrance to the gladiatorium training area. And here you can change your current loadout. So even if you don't go into the gladiatorium training area, this computer terminal nearby can be really useful to view and change your current loadout. So for this one, you don't talk to a person, you just interact with this screen. And of course, when you do start a mission, you'll have another chance to change your loadout if you wish. And one more bonus tip, you can change your armor skin by talking to the bartender. I don't want any problems. These are all free skins, except the one marked DLC that was a pre-order bonus I got for pre-ordering this game. These armor skins are cosmetic and don't affect your stats, just appearance. I did make another video on character creation, where you get to select among different preset characters. I'll link that on screen And it's also in my Hired Gun playlist, linked in the description below. So check that out and subscribe to my channel to get more guides and gameplay for Necromunda Hired Gun. This is Amber. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.